All right, and now Hebrews chapter 4, verses 1 through 3. Let us therefore fear, lest the promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. But unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. For we which have believed do enter into rest. As he said, as I have sworn in my wrath, if they shall enter into my rest, although the works were finished from the foundation of the world. He's talking here about the Hebrew children, how they did not enter into the physical rest of the promised land because they didn't believe God's promises. When they saw the giants, they believed more in the giants than they did in God. And he says, you know, they had a promise, they had a gospel, but it didn't do them any good because they didn't mix it with faith. You know, I encourage you, take these words that we're speaking, the word of God that we're speaking, and mix it with faith. Believe. Just when you hear the word of God, just say, yes, Lord, I believe. Yes, Lord, I believe. Yes, Lord, I believe. And just take it in and let him speak to your heart and give you that rest. Just say, thank you, Lord. I believe your gospel. I believe Jesus died for me to set me completely free. I take it in. I mix it with faith. I believe it's the truth, and it's for me. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. I enter into your rest. Lord, I just release the rest of God to this precious one in Jesus' precious name. Amen. All right. Now, Hebrews chapter 12, verses 12 through 15. Wherefore, lift up the hands which hang down and the feeble knees and make straight paths for your feet, lest that which is lame be turned out of the way, but rather let it be healed. Follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. You know, we can be defiled. We can be doing everything we can, you know, in our personal relationship with the Lord. But we can get tripped up in our relationship with people if we don't follow peace. You see, it doesn't mean we're going to accept everything everybody does and hang around with people that discourage us and so on. But we've got to have peace. You know, one of the best ways to do that is to pray. You know, pray for those, Jesus said, pray for those that despitefully use you and persecute you. Because, you know, you can't really be an enemy to somebody that you're praying for. So pray, have peace, don't be defiled, keep your heart clean, walk in the light, and that blessing will flow and the glory of God will be upon your life in Jesus' name. Hebrews chapter 13, verses 5 and 6, let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as you have. For he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. You know, the Lord made promises to us. For example, here he says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. That's a beautiful promise, you know, and if you believe that, then you have something to say. You can say, go ahead and say it now, just say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear what man shall do unto me. We live in a lot of anxiety about maybe what man will do unto us, what somebody's going to do to us, what's going to happen. But the Lord is with you. Nothing to worry about. It's all going to be okay. In Jesus' name. All right, Hebrews 13, 20 and 21. Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead the Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. The God of peace is going to keep working in you to do his perfect will. And I pray in Jesus' name for this precious one that's listening today, Lord, that you, as the God of peace, will continue to work, to will, and to do your good pleasure in them. And I say the word that we're speaking will continue to resound and resonate in their hearts day by day. Lord, they'll listen to this again and take it in and feed on it, Lord God, and it will minister to their soul over and over again. and it will produce life, and it will produce good things. Lord, you have a plan for victory for them. You have a plan for peace of mind, peace in their hearts, healing in their bodies, healing in their minds. Lord, if there's even something wrong chemically or hormonally, whatever it would be, if there's something wrong in the connectors in the brain, you're able to fix it all, Lord. So in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just lay hands on them sort of in the spirit, Lord. We just release the anointing to their mind and to their hearts, to their emotions. And we just release that power of God to bring peace today, because you, Lord, are there, right there with them. And you are the God of peace. Be healed in Jesus' name. Have peace in Jesus' name. I think how Jesus said to the woman with the issue of blood who was healed, go in peace and be healed of your plague in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Praise God. All right. A couple more scriptures. We're almost done. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13. Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. We need to gird up our minds, just like we're getting ready to run. We have to gird up, you know. Well, we have to gird up our minds. We have to get ready to move with God. Get ready for the good things that God's bringing in your life. Be expectant for his power to be released in your life. And then 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. How much care? All your care. Say, thank you, Lord. I cast all my care upon you because you care for me. Thank you, Lord, for loving me. Thank you for caring for me. Thank you for sending Jesus to die for me. I believe he rose again. I believe he is alive. And I welcome the Holy Spirit in my life to minister peace and every good fruit in Jesus' name. Well, God bless you, folks. It's been a joy to be with you. Peace be unto you in Jesus' name. Amen.